Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in his Independence Day speech, announced a plan to distribute fortified rice to the poor by 2024. He said that this could be accomplished under different schemes, including public distribution systems, or PDS, and midday meals. This year, on April 7th, the Union Cabinet approved a proposal to distribute fortified rice under all government schemes as a solution to tackle the problem of nutritional deficiency. The government will spend about Rs 2,700 crores per year on the scheme. But is it really worth it? But before that, first, let us understand what fortification is and why India requires it. What is rice fortification? Fortification is a process through which essential micronutrients in food are deliberately added to boost nutritional quality that helps improve public health. This is done by a process called extrusion. The micronutrients added to rice are iron, folic acid, vitamin B12, zinc, vitamin A, vitamin B1, vitamin B2, B3, and vitamin B6. Why rice fortification? India is the second largest producer and consumer of rice in the world, accounting for 20% of global production. Almost a third of Indians depend on rice for sustenance. According to the Food Ministry, India has very high levels of malnutrition among women and children. Every second woman in the country is anemic, and every third child is stunted. Thus, fortification of food is viewed as one of the most suitable methods to combat malnutrition. Per capita rice consumption in India is 6.8 kg per month. Therefore, fortifying rice with micronutrients is an option to supplement the diet of the poor. But is this fortification really necessary? Contemporary evidence indicates that iron deficiency is neither rampant nor omnipresent, and therefore does not require a universal mandatory solution.
If you look at it early in this century, at 2000, the RDA, as it was defined then, was 30 milligrams for iron for men and women, 30. And then in 2021, in 2020, we find that even better data coming out, that actually the requirement dropped even further. And in fact, now the requirement is 15 for women and 11 for men. When it was 30, everyone threw up their arms and said, my God, there is no way any diet in India can meet 30. And they were right. And that led to thoughts about fortification. But in reality, that was an inflated requirement. And as we've come to the more correct requirements, we find, well, you can actually meet the requirement very easily, at least as a well-nourished or richer population. And certainly there is a gap in the poor population, but it is not a big deal. It is 5 milligrams. I mean, the problem is that you have different lobbies wanting to do fortification, different lobbies wanting to do supplementation, and unfortunately, there doesn't seem to be a lobby for poor old diversification.
There is more to food and nourishment than just rice. Is just rice enough? What about diversity? It is an oxymoron that fortification will complement and coexist with dietary diversification. The NIN food plate for Indians stipulates that a diverse and healthy plate of food must not contain more than 40% of the total calories from cereals, of which only a fraction should be from rice. Yet the rice fortification is likely to instruct people to eat 250 to 350 grams of fortified rice per day.
That about 70%, 70% of all calories are coming from rice already. And that's a very dangerous, it's a danger signal that we are going wrong somewhere. People need oil, people need pulses, people need fruits, vegetables.
It is a hunger trap which is created, which creates panic amongst the policy or the important stakeholders who look for very simplistic solutions. Look at the mind-boggling cost of just fortifying the rice, not the cost of the rice, just fortifying raw rice at an annual rate of 2700 crore rupees annually. every year which is going to go there.
We need gentler, safer, long-term and sustainable solutions that involve the community and stimulate diet diversification. We must resist the fascination with technology and universality and go local for global problems.